Wrestling Fans, so welcome back to the channel, back to another reaction. They react, we're back with some more Queen. I know my Queen fans, my Queen subscribers are happy. I haven't forgot about you guys. I'm still doing Queen. I've been re-enjoying it. I love going back and listening to all music. And I love Freddie Mercury. Freddie Mercury is just incredible. His voice really was something else. And I just love doing reaction. They've been so good, especially songs I listened to before. And it's funny, a lot of the songs I've listened to as a kid, I just didn't look at who they were. And this is one of those songs, because this is a song that is so famous. It's been in so many movies, TV shows, books. It's been sung all the time. It's been redone a bunch of times. Like, it's kind of like a national anthem for the world, for people, for humanity. Take a reaction to We Are the Champions. And this is such a feel-good song. And it's just such a great song, because it really just empowers you and lifts you up. It makes you feel like you're a rock star too. So before we get into it, I do want to say a positive about the sign. I know that'd be that great, but I hope you guys still enjoy about the lighting as well. I know I'm working on getting better stuff for that, but I hope you be patient with me. You still enjoy. Also, I will be stopping it probably once or twice to talk about it. Because one, it does help with copyright when I do that. And two, I love getting my own 50 cents as well. Especially when this is something this great and they're saying really meaningful things. I love to, you know, get into that, crack it down, or break it down, and, you know, and get my sense of and get my opinion on it. So, but without further ado, let's get into the video.
I've paid my dues time after time. Done my sentence, but committed no crime.
Oh, Freddy.
And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
Well, you know.
I've had my sound and kicked in my face. My bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. I consider it a challenge before the human race, and I ain't gonna lose.
Sorry, guys, I know, but I just love the song. I really do. It's such a feel good song. And even a lot of things you're saying, like, you know, like he said, like in the beginning, you say, I've done my sins, I've committed no crime. And he's talking about all the things he had to go through to get to this extreme success that he is. And if he had a prejudice or anything, his only crime would be that he wanted fame success, which is the crime of any musician or artist who wants to be famous. Anybody who wants to be well known, your only real crime, I guess, where we do, you got to go through to get there, is the fact you wanted that in the first place, and you wanted so bad. Like he said, I made, and bad mistakes, I made a few, talking about how, you know, as human beings, we all make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes all the time, through things we're not proud of, through things we wish we could take back, but we should never let those mistakes define who we are. And we should always be able to keep moving. And he's not perfect. He's made mistakes, but he's kept moving. And then he said, I've had my sheriff saying kicked in my face, but I've come through. And he's talking about that's kind of like true, you know, you're sitting the beach somewhere, you're the nerdy kid, and the big strong jocks come out and just kicks in your face. And he's all talking about all the critics who probably banned last season. Because when he first got started, like, you know, he was kind of a weirdo. A lot of company regulars weren't really into that much. They had a lot of criticism, a lot of critics said a lot of bad things about him, and they threw a lot of shade in his face. But like you say, he came through and he needs to go on and on and on. Pretty much like how the music always has to go on, has to keep going, which I love that. And I love what he's saying. And even in the second race, he's talking about, you know, taking bows and curtain calls. You know, he's a big ass rock star. He's done thousands of, bows after performance. And you know, he said, you know, you brought me fame and fortune. Everything that goes with it, I thank you all. And he's talking to the fans, and I love that. I love it anytime a musician or artist recognizes, or actors, anybody recognizes the fans. Because without the fans, who would you guys be? You'd be nothing. You'd just be a guy who has a great talent. But all the people who go buy your stuff, wake up every day and night, listen to your music, who are crazy about you, the fanatics. Without them, who would you be? So I love the fact that he's thanking them. But also, he also talks about some of the bad things. Like I said, it's been no bed of roses, no pleasure cruise. And I think because, you know, the problem with famous people is that people, just because they're famous, they have a lot of money and stuff, people always think that nothing bad happens to them. They don't get sad that there's always good times. But no, that's not true, because behind closed doors, they can go through more hell than you are. And one of the problems with being famous and, you know, being a band, especially back then, like, you know, going on tour, you're away from friends, away from family. That's what we say, there's no pleasure cruise, because not everything's perfect, but people always assume it is. And, you know, he said, I consider that chance before the whole human race, I ain't going to lose. Just a lot of things that he's saying, I love it. Because even if you hear him, like, because I looked up, you hear him talk about this song. He said he wrote this song because he wanted to be, he was on the football field. He had a chance, and he wanted everybody to be able to sing along to feel inspired and empowered by his song. And he's definitely done that. But so, okay, let's finish it out. Crowd, but that's what I mean. Look how enjoyable the crowd was. That was awesome. That was awesome. I absolutely love that song. But that's the interview. That's the interview, guys. I hope you guys enjoy it, especially my Queen fans. Like I said, I'm not forgot with you guys. I know one person missed. I had like 120 something singles to go through, so I'm in it for a long haul. But I'm in it just because I love this group. I love Freddie Mercury, Brian May, John Deacon. I think his name is Rosin. Roger Tyler, Mikey Groves, Barry Mitchell. I think there are a few of Barry Mitchell, Bobby Biggle. But I just love this group from the guitar instrument to the stage performance. Because, you know, just like, even when you just saw the video, like, it started quiet, just boom, it just hits you. And just this beautiful music come out. And you got Freddie Mercury with his voice. And they truly are one of the greatest bands of all time. And it's a saying that he's still alive with us today, Freddie. You know, unfortunately, he lost his, you know, life to AIDS. But if he was still alive there, I wish I could go back time to see them in a concert during their prime, because it's truly amazing. Especially with a song, like I said, this song, it just gets you involved. You can see in the crowd, people were excited, because this type of song, like, if you're a loser and you're constantly being picked on, and they just makes you feel like a champ, like you're part, like you just won the Super Bowl or something, it makes you feel big, and I absolutely love that. But thinking about you stay, again, I'm sorry, but you know, the sounds are nice. I am working on getting very quick, but I still hope you enjoy it. And again, guys, you know, everybody's a champion. You know, you should always feel that you're the best. No matter what anybody says, everybody gets you down. This is a character, and I'm out. Peace.